Hey folks, Daily Lions Blog for the 20th of February, 2021. Yesterday, Kim reposted a story on our Facebook page. And the story essentially said, these are 32 symptoms of anxiety that people wish they knew others experienced. And I was thinking about how I would apply that to depression. And it's different for me. When I was a kid, if I would have known that other people were suffering from the same sorts of fears that I was, it would have probably changed my life. But depression was different. I was an adult. But what I could really have used is what I'm going to say now, which you may want to share with someone else. And that is, what I could have used was somebody telling me that it can happen so slowly that you don't know it's happening. If someone would have said, you know, Michael, you don't 100% seem like yourself. You may be feeling okay, but you know, this can happen insidiously. It can creep into you. It can be a tiny, tiny change that happens to you. And just bit by bit, like at night, someone comes and steals away just a tiny bit of you, that after enough nights, that stealing away and replacing it with something else changes who you are. And I had no idea that it could happen that slowly. And if I would have been alerted to it, if I would have known, I would have done something about it way earlier. So understand that depression can happen tiny bit by tiny bit. And it can be going on with you, in you, right now, without you really acknowledging it. And that's why you got to take inventory. You got to look and say, how do I feel today compared to how I felt 2 years ago? And can I experience the same joy today that I experienced 2 years ago? If I would have known that, I would have got help a lot sooner and I would not have gotten to the severe stage. SickNotWeek.com, 24 hours a day, 364 days a year. Ask me about my arm, Case.
Yeah, it's so natural how you're sitting there.
I'm not showing it off or anything like that. This is the big day for me. Anybody who's watched this blog is rolling their eyes going, okay, yeah, November 24th, 2008, Marriott Hotel in Montreal, room 521, 4 a.m. in the morning. We know, Michael, that's when you understood suicide. But you know what? It may help someone else. Thanks for noticing.
You're welcome.